Ang araw po sa inyo, ito na naman po ako. Meron po tayo isang tatalakayan tungkol din po ito sa ating mga manok na sasabungin. Pinamagatan po itong Anatomy of a Gamecock by Floyd Garley. Part 1. If one has some knowledge of the structure of the gamecock, it will help him to understand both health and disease. Fowl are fast living creatures in comparison to other animal. They are also highly specialized in comparison to other animals. Most of these adaptations have to do with for flight. Their coating of feathers sets them apart from other forms of life. Also, the fact that the development of their young for the most part take place outside the mother's body, they have a very high metabolic rate and the body temperature is higher than most other animals. In the healthy birds, the temperature varies from 105 degrees Fahrenheit to 109.5 degrees Fahrenheit, with the average temperature being 107.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Fowl have high pulse rate and are rapid breathers. The breath rate of fowl at roost at night is about 14 to 22 times per minute and have a heartbeat of about 300 times per minute by any excitement will cause rapid acceleration in the heart rate. In a 24 hours old chick, it was observed that the dropping caused the heart rate to increase from the normal 300 to as much as 560 beats per minute. The fowl respiratory system is very different from that of mammals. The trachea connects the larynx with the syrinx of lower larynx, where the trachea divides into the two bronchi. The air sacs are necessary for voice production, for if the cervical air sacs are punctured, no sound can be emitted. The lungs are firmly attached to the rib cage. The bronchus pass through the entire length of the lungs and connect with the abdominal air sacs. This makes the air sacs important reservoir for oxygen. It is reported that there are no blind ends to the bronchial system, and it's probable that the oxygen moves more or less continuously through the respiratory system instead of in and out of the lungs as it does in mammals. There are four pairs of eight air sacs ranging in position from the neck of the abdomen. They connect with the cavities of hollow bones. That the connection with the bones is really substantial is shown by the statement of Bibi in 1906, who reports that a duck with its upper wings bone broken with shot is able to breathe through the splinter in one of the bone when the windpipe are completely black with clotted blood. The skin of the fowl is comparatively thin and consists of the outer layer called the epidermis. The inner layer is called the dermis. When the pigment of the dermis is black and the epidermis is white, looking through the epidermis of white at black in the dermis, the shank appears to the blue. Just as when white paint and black paint are mixed, you will have a blue color. When the epidermis is yellow and the dermis is black, the shank appears green. Just as yellow and black paint will produce green color. Just as yellow and black paint will produce green color, when the epidermis is white and the dermis is white, you have white leg. When the epidermis and the dermis of both, you have a yellow shanks. In the areas which are covered with feathers, the epidermis is dry and covered with fine scales. These scales are constantly being shed and replaced as new skin tissue is formed. There are no sweat glands in a chicken skin, only the pring gland at the base of the tail, the scales of the shanks and feet, the toenails, beak, and feathers are modification of the epidermis, while the comb, wattles, and earlobes are development of the dermis. The skin is sensitive to touch, stimuli applied to the feathers. It is also supplied with muscle by which the feathers are provided with a considerable amount of movement. Feathers partly embedded in the pallids of the epidermis vary gently in size, shape, and color. Not only do they protect the pall from physical injury, but are a great aid in keeping the body warm. The wing feathers are of course necessary to flight and balance. The feathers are arranged in a very definite patterns called feather struct. There are three types of feathers: plumules, pyloplumes, and contour feathers. The plumules are small, downy feathers which are completely covered by the contour feathers in adult birds. The pyloplumes are excessively slender and difficult to see. They appear as hair-like structure and are never developed in sufficient number to be of any value as covering. They are really degenerate feathers in which the side branches never become attached in the shaft. Being shed at the shaft grows, they are entirely covered by the contour feathers. Contour feathers come in various forms of size and color. They include the body feathers, the wing and tail feathers. The parts of a typical feathers include the quill or shaft, which includes the hollow portion of the shaft. The barbs branching from the shaft and the barbular branching from the barbs, and the barbicles branching from the barbules. The smooth appearance of such feathers are the wing primaries is brought about the fine hooks on the barbicels that serve by holding the parts together. The complex part of a feather is apparent from the statement of BB in 1906, when he estimated that there were 100-200 barbs, as nearly 1 million separate barbules on one wing feathers. The large feathers of the wing and tail are of a definite number, and they are molded and replaced in a defined order. This is very useful to poultry men because it gives a basis to estimate the length of time that a hen has been out of production and when they should start to lay again. In all fowl, there are three kinds of muscle. The smooth muscle found in the walls of the alimentary canal, blood vessel, and other tubular structure of the body are called involuntary muscles. The voluntary muscles are the edible portion of the fowl and are used in moving the various parts of the skeleton. The third kind in the heart muscle, which is of course involuntary but which also has characteristic of the voluntary muscles and is generally placed in a class by itself. A fact about the muscle system of the bird, which deserves special mention in the development of the large muscle, which control the major movement of the wings. The greater part of this muscle group is on the body proper because of the extensive attachment for the breastbone. This muscle weighs about as much as all the rest of the muscle combined and makes about 1/12 of the entire body weight. An interesting thing about the muscle of the leg and feet in the reflex nature of roosting, the toes are automatically flexed when his knees join or bend. The fowl is therefore able to grasp the perch with no effort and is prevented from falling while asleep. Okay, part 2.